Chicago PD decided to shoot an unarmed young individual, shoot at them while at the same time claiming they were being shot at. Nothing like that happened. These cops have now been arrested. Let me take you to the video first. Here it is. A police watchdog group was able to get this video released. It shows officers shooting two men in a case that led to felony charges for these cops. You're going to see basically what looks to be a targeted assassination. There is absolutely no prerequisite to their action. They were not provoked. They were not in fear. They were not in danger. This was insane. You see the individuals on the camera. You're going to also see the police pull up unmarked, plain clothes. Nobody knows they are the police. And they decide to shoot without provocation. Do you hear me? They shot. Driving up to the scene, just started shooting with zero provocation. They have been arrested. Let me first put up the picture of the man who was wearing the white hoodie. 23-year-old Miguel Medina. He did not have a weapon. He did not fire a weapon. He did not try to harm those two officers. The reason why this is an important element is because the police report signed by both of these cops said that he in fact shot at them, that they were simply defending their lives. These are the two officers. Let's put them up. On the left, you have Ruben Reynoso. Right, you have Sergeant Christopher Liakopoulos. They are now charged. The two cops claimed they returned fire after shots were fired at them early on the morning of July 22nd. The officers were not hit, but two other people were wounded, one seriously. But the Cook County State's Attorney, Kim Fox, said at a news conference Friday, the officers' claims were completely contradicted by videotape evidence. The officers did not have provocation or justification to shoot the unarmed victim. Evidence does not support use of deadly force. Let's put up the picture of the prosecuting DA, Ms. Fox. She said those words during a press conference. Here's some more context. The officers who were once again in plain clothes with Liakopoulos at the wheel of an unmarked squad car were headed to a training course when they stopped, according to them, to investigate a group of people in the 1000 block of West 18th Street. Assistant State's Attorney Alyssa Janicki said during the officer's hearing, because they were on their way to training, neither was wearing a body-worn camera, she said. As the officers talked to the group, Gail Medina, 23, and a 17-year-old child with a satchel across the front of his body approached. Medina was holding a wine bottle and cell phone in one hand, but his other hand was empty. Medina was standing at the passenger side window of the squad car and showing officers both his hands. When one cop extended his arm from the window of the squad car, pointed a gun. The other cop also reached for his gun and leaned across Reynoso as both officers opened fire, striking Medina in the back and the leg, according to the prosecutor. What do you think that is? In the story and said these were Piru blood gangsters or Crips. You would say, oh, that was a targeted attack, drive-by shooting, targeted assassination, gang related. But then when I let you know that the police did it, the exact same set of facts. And then when I contextualize it by saying the police did it, all of a sudden there's a nuance to the narrative. Why? Don't fall for the indoctrination. They take advantage of the fact that they know people would trust them no matter what. They take advantage of that and they utilize it as leverage to continue to brutalize communities all over this country. Now it's not just black folk. Now we do get the harsher end of this. but they will brutalize you too. They will brutalize whoever stands in their way until accountability takes place. There's more to this story. The 17-year-old took off running, grabbing a gun from his satchel and firing at the officers. I don't blame him. Plainclothes individuals all of a sudden shooting at you. The cops lied on the police report. The cops have been indicted. The cops are bad people. The cops started this. And according to them, they were just trying to check out some guys while on their way to training. And they just happened to not have on anything that identified them as police. Sharon, what are your thoughts on this?
This is mafiosa type behavior that only Sammy the Bull could appreciate. This is so scary, Dr. Yeah. Richey. This is horrific what we've seen. What else have they done? And why are we talking about, thank God they're arrested, but was it justified? These are cold-blooded, probably killers. We know they tried to kill some people. This is absolutely stunning. And there appears to be zero provocation here. Like the DC snipers, they're just going through the community and trying to blow people away. You're right. The one who ran away, it is self-defense. But I wonder when we will get it. There's got to be others who knew that this pair existed on the force. There's yeah. got to be others like them too.
Absolutely. And let's be very clear, okay? If a person can somehow say, well, what Kyle Rittenhouse did was self-defense, and then say what the 17-year-old did was criminal, that's just an insane comparison. The 17-year-old saw two individuals without provocation trying to kill him. Let's eliminate the talking point for a moment. Let's get outside of the indoctrination of law enforcement. Let's just talk about common sense and humanity. If you have two people shooting at you, you have done nothing to provoke them. You have no idea who they are. You have not engaged them in any way. What are you going to do? You're going to try to defend yourself. And that's precisely why those cops have not been indicted. They are being prosecuted for the felonies they committed that day.